sweet, warming tones of the astral strings that vibrate throughout the ageless.
Yeah, keep on keeping on. We're going back.
There, among the stars. The cosmic breeze that brings the ravishing chance of knowledge. Old as time itself. I keep falling through these vortexes to the darkest depths of space where colors are hurt.
Oh, no, no, no. I don't think there's any continuity between Grimrock and Grimrock 2. At least none that I recall. Okay, so there's one, two walls in here we can cut down.
I can still hear the song. Long after the phonograph stopped.
But yeah, like if you want dungeon crawlers, I would honestly just recommend skipping Grimrock 1 unless you want like unless you're really like looking for another dungeon crawler to like dungeon crawl through. Grimrock 2 is just better in absolutely every way.
What? This is my phono diary, but I have no memory of ever seeing these words. What the hell was I even babbling on about? Strings, vortexes, age of ravishing, whatever. I recall Diana Winters insisting that I played some recordings of the Fumium Core, but really, I must have been drunk out of my mind to record such crap.
Yeah, like, Grimrock 1 isn't a bad game at all. It's just Grimrock 2 does, like, literally everything it does, but more and better. Weapon damage upgrade, nice. Cutter drone. We were hauling some crates from the workshops down to the docks yesterday. Boys from the Fumium Core were supposed to take them from there. For a second, I lost balance and the crate slipped from my grip and broke into pieces. Guess what was in it? A cutter drone, the same thing we use in the workshop. This one came alive and started to fly around me. I was never so scared in my life. You know what those things could do, right? The rays cut through wooden planks like a hot knife through butter. Just kept circling around me, observing my every move. Dude, I was so helpless. If it had turned on the ray, if only for a second, not even an exo-rig would have done anything about it. I had no idea what to do. Do I run? Do I hunker down? Do I stand as still as a stone? Will the beast stand down or provoke an attack? Then Runkolf showed up and shut the damn thing down. I was never so happy to see that old grump, but if he hadn't been there, one thing's for sure, no crate will ever slip from my hands again. Okay. Color mold.
I should be able to put both molds to use back at the fountain.
Oh, well that's able to hit me through walls? Okay. Holy shit. These enemies are just nuts. Christ. Sure thing, Pinky. Not a problem. Like, basically the only thing that I could recommend, the only reason I could recommend playing Grimrock 1 is if you want, like, another dungeon to explore. But Grimrock 2 is a very big game. It is much larger than you would think at first. Like, you'll be like, oh, you know, I found, you know, everything I was gonna find. And then you just find, like, a completely different area that's, like, half the size of the first game. And it's like, oh. Pretty great. I would have to look, but I know, like, my first playthrough of it was probably, like, I don't even know, like maybe 30 hours, probably more than that. A very chunky game. Energy cells. I think I've used a grand total of one energy cell in the entire time we've been playing here. Oh no, I just have a death beam bot. Well, we have two death beam bots because one death beam isn't enough. Oh my god, we're dead. It would be nice if they could, like, death beam each other. But something tells me that the game's not going to do that, is it? you just can't avoid it. You just die. These things are terrible. Yeah, and of course their death beams don't do anything to the other death beam bots. Because why would they do that? Oh my god. This is ridiculous. Yeah, the Eye of the Beholder games are kind of an exception. Like, Eye of the Beholders, Lands of Lore... Like, I've played those games so much that, like, it's kind of unfair to compare to that to normal game through, because, like, I don't even need maps for those games anymore. Okay, and there's our level. Nice. Which this is actually health regen. I'm very thankful for. Up to 25%, so that should give us, like, what? 200 and change hit points. Not too bad. Thank you very much for the follow. I appreciate it. And with that... Let me strip the metal off of this thing now. Yes. This is gonna give us scrap.
Great!
Hull plating.
I should be able to patch up my submarine's hull with this.
Okay, so with that... We'll go back and take a look at the submarine before we go back up into the workshop. Maybe. That might be the case, Pinky. Ah, hell. At the same time, like, while I tend to play these games pretty quickly, I tend to miss a bunch of stuff due to that, too, though. Like, I'm sure that I've missed secrets and whatnot. Oh, we're in a bad place. Oh, no. Ow. Ha! Eat shit. Stun yourself, you jerkbot. Ah, I love it. Oh, thank you very much, Jack. I appreciate it. Glad you're enjoying yourself. Always makes me happy to know that God, keeping folks entertained. Oh, we're gonna die. Don't die. Nope. There we go. We died. I even hit the heal button and it just didn't heal me. Totally not esports related failure on my part. Oh, I shouldn't be surprised I didn't deal any damage to you, huh? I love that they stun themselves. It just makes me unreasonably happy. Oh, totally worth it. Oh, that's one of them down. Let's get the other one. I do need to say esports more often. Yes, I've been lacking in the esports. Okay, so there's that.
I need material. A fumium ingot in here.
Yeah, we don't have your ingot, lady. Also, it's pronounced ingot. As you've pronounced it previously. Alright. Shiny new hull acquired. Now we need food and charging and a propeller and... We have a lot ahead of us. We need everything, basically. Sure. It kind of irks me that the welding torch is an inventory item, as opposed to, like, just some flag it sets on us. Because it's, like, taking up a space in our inventory, but it's something that is, like, mandatory to progress in the game. I don't know. Maybe I'm just picking nits. So that gets us back up top. Okay, let's see what hell crawl awaits us up here. More friggin' laser drones. Okay, we can't go that way, because death and madness. Yeah, grinder key, we can't go that way.
I'm a serious adventurer!
I am only the most serious of adventurers at all times. We are not here for levity or fun, we are here to play shitty dungeon crawlers and listen to me bitch about it. So we can't do anything there, and I don't think we can do anything with these, can we? Additives? I don't have any additives. Wait a minute. We already looted the drawers. Dang it! Thought I was being clever and finding something. Yeah, like, that's the thing, is, like, don't make key items take up inventory space. Especially in games where, like, your inventory space is kind of at a premium. Like, this shit drives me nuts. It can also make it, like, hard to find the stuff. I'm the same with keys. Like, I would much rather have, like, just a key ring item. Like, if you're gonna force me into having something in my inventory, just give me, like, a key ring and leave it at that. And then just, like, let me mouse over it and tell me what keys I have. Smells like fuego down there. We can't see it. Can I kill you guys? No. Can't kill you, I just can't move through you. Alright. Oh no. I don't imagine. Oh, that's some fucking horse shit. I don't like that at all. Oh, this is gonna make this such a pain in the ass to do. Oh, can we not hurt these things either? Well, that's just wonderful. Thank you, game. You dick. There's a button over there. But to get to it, flamethrowers. Oh, do I turn them? Ah, I see what I have to do, and I hate it. There. And I'm gonna save just in case they kick back on. Ever played a game with a proper keyring? Like, a lot of old DOS games had keyrings, but they tended to be like, oh, this is an inventory slot that basically functions as a bag and you just put all your keys into it. So it didn't necessarily save you as much space as you would like. Oh, there's a button over there. Jesus. Well, now... Oh, I see what I'm supposed to do. I was gonna say, how in the hell am I supposed to get to that? But... we have to lay this down. Hit the pressure plate. Spin these guys so that we can go. And we can just go around. Ultima 7. Oh my god, Ultima 7. See, like, I'm not gonna say I like the inventory in Ultima 7, but I used to love the inventory system in Ultima Online, which is basically the exact same as Ultima 7's. But I liked it purely because you could use it to fuck with people. Because people could, like, rob you in that. They'd steal shit from you. Really? 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 You fucks. They'd steal shit from your inventory. And, like, you could just, like, stack a bunch of bags in there and just make, like, a maze through your bags that they would have to navigate to be able to get your things. But yeah, from an actual inventory management standpoint, it was terrible. Ultima 6 was really bad for that, too. basically, okay, seriously, what the fuck is... Oh, there's a pressure. I didn't even notice that there was a pressure plate right there. Okay. This actually isn't that bad. I just need that. Yeah, Anvil of Dawn is about as extreme as I would ever want to go. It's not like a make or break thing for me, because like... I can make a navigable inventory if I need to. And honestly, I would prefer that kind of inventory than like a game where it just gives you like a list of items. But realistically, like this style of inventory is probably my favorite. Just give me like a grid and let me move things around in it. It's good enough. Switcher, switch your position with the enemy in front of you. Gimmicks. Wonderful. Fumium projection experiment day 42. The original estimate of working on the functional prototype was 2 weeks delay. The unexpected complications have caused a 4 week delay. We have managed to create static projections with fairly predictable properties, and that's all great. But of course, there's a but, and we have yet to solve the other problem, how to get rid of them. So far, we've been unable to decompose a single projection, and we should come up with and we should already have been testing live ones by this time. I'm sure we'll come up with a solution eventually. For the time being, Runcrofts lent us his newest gadget, the Switcher. At least we can move around a little, if we can call it that. But it of course takes up a slot in our otherwise limited slots of stuff. Whoa. Also, it takes points.
This always gives me the shivers. Crafty Runcroft once again proved his genius. Putting the whole teleportation technology into this tiny gadget is no small feat. Sure, the distance is pretty minimal, but still, what a handy thing.
Yeah, man, it's so fucking handy. Woo. Oh, that would be a way to backstab things, though. Because it does get us behind them. Tentatively might actually be useful. Popped a fucking... I keep hitting R to take everything. I don't even know what game I've been playing where R is take all, but it's apparently something and it's ingrained in my head, making me waste repair kits. Raccoons and roaches. What? Didn't I say it? That Jane Shane's person feeding my fruit to the giant roaches? Why does it have to be roaches? I wouldn't put up with such dirty, nasty beats in my house. Once a pair of raccoons made their home in my attic. We got along well. I used to bring them food, but then they grew to about 50 little marauders and were throwing parties every single night. I think they even had a bouncer. When I went to go up, they wouldn't let me in. I told them, this ain't gonna work. If you keep this up, you'll have to go. See, I tended them and cared for them, and I was generous, and that's what I got back in return. Boy, oh boy. But the roaches now, ugh. If I bumped into one somewhere out there, I'd be scared out of my wits. Ancient message. The singing coordinates music, huh? I feel like I'm losing it too at times. Laura Reich requested Liam's whole work today. By the way, where is Liam? I haven't seen him in days. Anyway, I can't give the Arius to Laura alone, at least not the whole thing. She can't usurp the knowledge all for herself. Fortunately, she charged me with collecting all of Liam notes and logs out of his observations. Before I hand them over, I must make copies to save at least parts of the ancient message lying dormant for millions of years on the seabed. What is it singing to me? What does it want? Doesn't want to show me. People going a little bit Cthulhu crazy. What? No. could have sworn, because it goes, all right, that's three. Oh, no, I see it. Okay. They're trolling. We can't, yeah, we can't actually make this. At least not yet. I think. There's a way for us to make it through this. Because, like, it waits two pushes, but this is the only one that doesn't push. I don't even know what happened there. Unless it has something to do with this pressure plate, maybe. Where did the pressure plate turn it on? Oh, we've got that brick. We gotta throw the brick. Oh, I hate this. I hate this a lot. Oh. We're dead. Yep. Okay, so the brick didn't do anything. No, maybe it did. Maybe it did change the last one. Can't tell. I think it did. I think I'm just miscatching it. Oh my god. Yeah, I'm just mistiming it, I think. Oh my god! So bad. There we go. Jesus. Okay, what do we got? Grinder key.
I understand, I always have. Laura's unceasing passion, that charming, childlike gleam in her eyes, that's why I fell in love with her and probably also married her. But now I'm afraid it's getting out of control, or rather, taking full control over her. Despite my direct order, she goes out of her way to keep the research going, and so do the people on her team. I warn her. I can turn a blind eye to some minor incidents and mishaps, but the pace she has set is furious. And if something serious happens, will I be an uncompromising warden of the greatest project the world has ever seen, or a loving husband ready to protect his dearest one? I just don't want her to put me on the spot and force my hand. I feel like I'm losing her somewhere in there.
Because you are, dude. She's completely fucking insane and is, like, turning people into sausage. Come on, now. This is, like, the shittiest fucking thing, this being right here. Oh, fuck off. Jerks. Like, really? Really? Fuck you. It feels like a lot more than in the previous game. Like, they're getting, like, some serious troll potential in on the level design here. I don't know how much I approve. A little bit is fine, but feels like they're taking it a little bit too far. I am digging this sword, though. I have to say that. Space bar to take all items. I was going to say I'll change it to R, but R is our healing potion, and I've already got that. Not our healing potion. Our repair kits. And I've already gotten that kind of ingrained. It's not probably a bad idea. So this. So, what exactly? Am I expected to do here? Like, I mean, obviously this projectile has to get here, but like, how? Does this have like a, no, this only has a one tile range, so like we can't even reach that dude from over here. I don't know. Let's go poke at the grinder, I guess. We're apparently not ready for that. F4 to hide the interface. Cute. Oh, what are you guys gonna do to me in this room? What horror awaits? A push gun deals no damage but knocks enemies back. Sounds important.
Push gun. Kareen Steele told me about this toy. Now I need some spiders to create enough scrap for the smelter.
Push gun. Not exactly a wonder of technology or anything like I was expecting, but it will suffice. Runcroft sent us one of his newest inventions, if you can call it that. A sonic resonance amplifier, and some other clever words I can't even pronounce. Everybody calls it the push gun. Better than nothing. At least we don't have to get too close to the spiders when filling the grinders. As a safety precaution, we've rigged the doors to only open when the gun is safely put in one of the containers, so that it never leaves the grinder room. The electric needle room. Alright. So does this take, what, energy? Or is it just a freebie? No, it's just a freebie. Okay. Render unto me, Spider Bros. Please? Spiders? No? Yes? No. Alright, fine. Apparently we're not ready to do spider slaying yet. Potion goes there. Sword goes there.
Director Reich is leaving. The only other man with some semblance of stature around here. Well, a foot soldier who happened to be picked by the Supreme Bureau to become a war hero. Every war needs a hero. If there's none, you have to make one. People have a need for fairy tales. Standard politics. And if anybody thinks his position here is earned in any way, they're helplessly naive. It's just dumb luck, nothing else. In comparison, my ability to withstand the stress of teleportation has nothing to do with luck. It's just sheer mental prowess. Where others have failed, left broken in their minds and bodies, I shine. And now, I'm to play centerpiece in the latest teleport chain experiment. After all the mishaps, I finally found my place. I'll finally make a name for myself. Soon.
I hate this. This is terrible. This is terrible. Like, I guess I gotta give the devs props for some clever puzzle design, but like, they suck. I'm sorry. Sorry, Brobot, you're dead. No, no, you're not. Quick save. It's like, up. Left. Oh no, there's a wall there. Shit. Pressure plate. This reminds me of... There's a series of quests in Dungeons & Dragons online And this reminds me of them. Oh, we can buffer movements in the thing. Okay, that actually makes this a little bit easier. Right, and I can go like that and it'll figure out. No, okay, so we can buffer a movement in the thing. Imagine doing this without saving. It's just terrible. Yeah, there's a series of quests in DDO that...
Okay, there should be plenty of water.
Like, you have to guide a rat through a maze.
Just waiting to be scrapped.
And it just fucking sucks. It's terrible. Okay, so now we're gonna have Spider Bros in here. Alright. Come on, Spider Bros, let's do this. The grinder's hunger. Not going the right way, Spider Bro. No, over here. Come on. Seriously, guys. Like, you just. I'm gonna feed myself to the machine. Tired of this shit. Now, equip the thing. There we go. In you get. In you get. I'm just gonna fucking cheese their movement. Anytime that they don't move where I want them to move, I'm just gonna quick load. There. Grinder appeased. Phew. Purely based on RNG movement.
I think the smelter is filled with enough scrap now.
Alright, smelter is good. Container for additives. I think we have additives. Okay, well, we can't do that. Journal, what am I supposed to be doing? You'll need a fumium solution, plenty of scrap. Alright, so we have scrap, so we just don't have the solution, which... Honestly, I have no idea where we're supposed to get that. I assume these just kill you if you step into them otherwise. There. No, that's just a conveyor belt. I'm gonna say, is there a path back there? Not so much. Curious, like, from a logistics standpoint, why is this here? Why don't they just have a conveyor belt going from there that takes them to be ground? Why is there a puzzle? Doesn't make any sense. My immersion! Okay, but seriously though, I have no idea where I should be going right now. Maybe, yeah, that might be, but like, I mean, if they're just being ground down for repurposing, does it matter if there are rejects? I don't know. Have so many questions. So many questions and no answers. Okay, scrap is full. Material output doesn't have anything. Special additives. I feel like an energy cell in or something. No. Notes. This is gonna give us anything, is it? No, it's just monsters and stuff. This game and its deep lore are just completely breaking me. I don't know, like, if they have a random maze for little critters to buzz through, like, there's gotta be a reason, right? But they're not telling me, and they're not, like, are they going, like, Dark Souls lore, where they expect the community to just kind of figure it out on their own? Is that what I should be doing here? Okay, that's nothing. I feel like we should go up this way, but I don't think we can unless I missed something. Which I suppose wouldn't surprise me. It's like, there's, can I like teleport over here? No. Can't do anything with that. Can't do anything with that. There is a passage down here, but I don't think we can get that far down without getting emulate. I have an idea. I'll let a fireball hit this guy. Teleport. Oh, I think we can make that. Okay, I think I know what we have to do. Maybe. Seriously? You got me during the cast time. I'm sorry that my pacing wasn't frame perfect. Fucking game. Jesus, the timing on that is tight. Ah, okay, there we go. I'm gonna follow this down. I wanna see what this does. Okay, that opens, or turns on a light, which apparently turned off the fuego. All right, system works. Clearly, esports. All right. I do have to say that I dig how much more varied the tile sets are in this compared to the first game. Like, the first game felt like it was a lot of just, like, rusty hallways. Whereas this is just like, we've got like rooms like this where it's like brickwork and stuff. I think it looks a lot better. I don't know how I killed that thing, but I'm gonna say esports. Oh, here we go. Alloy mixture, that's what we needed. Max energy and seed of doubt. Haskerman and his insights, oh my. The guy should be studying the substance and its practical use, but all he does is lament about how it affects our minds, our thinking, and our very thoughts. I would entertain the possibility that research like that could somehow, someday, be of use. But the way he goes about it is just wrong. Accusing Laura of willingly opening her arms to Fumium to be taking over and taken control of? Really? That's the conclusion now. Are you some kind of award-winning psychologist who can read people's minds? It's laughable. I don't care about what people believe, I care about data. And in this case, I admit the data is interesting. It's actually the reason I'm writing this down. After all, there may be some truth to it. Of course, not to disagree. Not to the degree Haskerman claims, but enough for a seed of doubt. Alright. 5% max energy. Feels good, man. It feels like the progression in this was quicker, or has been quicker. Really? Really? So now the drones are attacking us because reasons. And for some reason we can hurt them. Is it because we have this alloy mixture in our inventory? Is it because the devs wanted to just say, screw you, get fucked? I don't know, I don't care, but I'm annoyed. Mm. Okay. Friggin' devs and their chicanery. All right, make me a thing. Unlimited power. Eventually. Now we have some ingots. All right.
I think that's all I need for the foundry downstairs.
Well, that's nice. I guess we're done on this level then. Neat! That wasn't too painful. Except for all the things that were painful, but you know, we survived. We got through it. Let's go make a propeller. And then it'll be all about finding foodstuffs. Wait, what? We got teleporting robots now. I don't approve of this. Okay, I have to say that the switch has thus far proven to be actually quite useful. 10 of 10 would employ again. Just waiting for a boss fight. We have had, I think the first game had boss fights in it, if I recall correctly. Okay. Oh, here we go. Aha! Do the thing! I mean, I remember the final boss fight in the game, obviously, but I think there were like some of the big brutes that we fought. Yeah. Forbidden Jello. Killer Pudding. Pretty sure those things would probably take longer than that pool, but okay.
Nice. The submarine should swim like a dolphin with this piece.
Alright, now what do we need? We have to charge it and find food and decontaminate an area. Alright, I don't have any keys. There are no locked doors on this level. Okay. So we actually need to go, looks like down to the construction bay or up. And I don't think we can go up, yeah.
I need a key.
Okay, so down to the construction bay. Wish 3D printing was that fast. No kidding. Holy crap, that'd be great. Minis in seconds instead of hours. Ah. So good. Alright, so where... See, the problem is that I have no idea like where the hell we're supposed to go, because I don't have... We have no keys. We have many doors. Okay, and then from here... We gotta go to hydroponics, it looks like. Alright, and we'll see if there's anything else we can get into in here. Should it be that fast eventually? Probably. Well, yeah, probably eventually. I don't know how long that's gonna take, but... Because, I mean, like, you can get resins and stuff that cure quickly. I don't know about that quickly. But, yeah. What's down here? Why did I never explore this? Did I get distracted? Was I being a coward? Is it a combination of both? Have we been in here? Looks like possible loot. Yes, okay. We were like just in here maybe an hour ago and I remember none of this. Is there a downside to the fast curing ones? No, not to my knowledge. I mean, they can cost more, but that's about it. And like,
I need a key.
Different resins can have like different potential uses of fumium and casting, like durability and stuff. And centering. Like there's resin now, it's called like 8K so far, resin, and it's supposed to be like super flexible, which as the magical substance I might look into because regular resin is super, super, super fragile. Wonder everyone's making it out to be. I'd rather think we're dealing. Yeah, that's right. This is where we had the asshole bug. So don't forget about
with
him.
A classical case of wishful thinking here. We're spending unholy amounts of resources on this whole shebang just to tinker with this thing so it better perform the way we want. Especially considering the average IQ of these, scientists. On the other hand, the exo-rig technology's pretty damn cool. I got to try one out today, and geez, it's just badass. It gives you so much power, and all the gadgets you can plug in and make stuff happen in a flash. To be honest, I'd rather be working with these babies than getting bored to death with that old fart of a metallurgist.
I assume that this is instant kill, right? Yes, it is. Okay. That just closes this. So we have death gas. There's nothing for us if we go up top because we've already gotten as far as we can in there. Anything down in the testing facility, maybe? Came in. But I assume this is the air conditioning facility right here, based on what the map looks like. And there's stairs and there's a ladder. I have a feeling that we're missing something in hydroponics, like we've missed a secret somewhere or something. Playing good shots in Space Engine. Universe has a lot of repetition. I mean, I guess that's the downside when you find really good shots, that sometimes it gets hard to find new and better shots. Alas. Regardless, though, I think I'm actually going to go ahead and call it here. And I will see you all next week.